Recently, I moved from Melbourne to Sydney. I lived in Melbourne for about 10 years, and I wasn't too sure what to expect from his neighboring city. What's the weather like, and what's it like for cycling? Cycling in cities of car-centric countries is still a challenge, and Sydney is no exception. The roads can get rather crowded with cars. And as a cyclist, you always have to fight for your position because the majority around you consider it a race. Now, I'm not a fan of this type of riding. It's an assault to your senses, as are the roadworks, by the way. It interrupts your flow, which is what cycling is all about. But once you turn left or right, away from other ones' race, this is where it gets interesting. For example, you can head to Sydney's beaches in the northern and eastern suburbs. This is where the roads follow the hilly topography of the areas. So there's a lot less cars and a lot of steep streets. Ideal for some hill wraps, which I like to do, just going up and down. And because the climate is subtropical out here, the city is full of these lush nature reserves, a little escape from the city's hustle and bustle. Although I used to race criteriums a bit before, from time to time I still like to pretend I'm in one. Going on an early attack, establishing a breakaway. This is probably why my friends designated my spirit pro to be Thomas the Gent, always attacking, always trying. Since the move to Sydney, I've been wanting to dust off my camera and capture the city sights and sounds and make a short film about it. So I started sketching some of these ideas that I had on paper, a bit of storyboarding of what I want to show and tell. And it's been a way to motivate myself to get out there and explore. It's this curiosity that's been showing me around the city. Experiencing the textures and the tastes, and indulging in a bit of the cafe culture. Perfect reward after a ride, coffee and a croissant. And what Sydney has shown me, apart from the impressive icons like the Harbour Bridge and the Opera House, is that all of the things that I haven't explored or experienced in this city yet, they are a reason to get out there. And with my bike, it's the best way to do that.